Hello everyone, I've already produced two tutorials on how to make video lectures. In the first tutorial, I showed you how to make video lectures using Open Broadcast Studio, how to record a video lecture. In the second session, we also saw how to edit the video lecture. Now going forward, and as I'm keeping on researching different tools, I've gone through around more than 10 different tools for capturing as well as editing. I've fumbled upon this one tool called BANDICAM, which is a very simple tool to use for recording your screen as well as recording your video at the same time. And I've come across this another tool called OpenShot, which is an again open source video editing software which can be easily used for editing. So let's look at these two tools, and as I always say, plan to record the session. This is my plan for this session. Yes, now let's see how we can use BANDICAM to record the screen as well as the webcam. So let's go ahead and record using BANDICAM software. So you can open up the BANDICAM window. Now BANDICAM is a software which you can download from bandicam.com. Once you download it, an installation process is pretty straightforward. Everyone can do it. Now once you download and open the software, the window will appear something like this. Now if you see over here the window, there are different options here in the left hand side, that is home, general, video. The first three options is what we have to be careful about before we start a recording. Now in the home option, you can go and see here, there are different types of recording screen options. Now you can record a specific area in the screen by screen recording mode option. You can record the entire screen by full screen option, and you can record a particular amount of screen around your mouse. Whichever is suitable for you, go ahead and do it. I would always recommend go for full screen record option. In the general option, you can always set a path for where your recorded video will be saved into. By default, there will be a location, but you can always change the location by clicking the option over here. Now, this next option that you need to be worried about is the video option. Now, here you can find there are different options in the record. The first option is the record stop hotkey. Setting up a hotkey is very useful. Please go ahead and do it. Hotkey is a shortcut key which can be used to start the record even when your BANDICAM screen is minimized. There is the next option is pause hotkey. Please go ahead and choose this pause hotkey also. That is shift plus F12. Now this again is a very useful tool because pause hotkey helps you to pause in between your lecture. If suppose you have fumbled, if you have stopped your lecture for some reason, if there was some interference, you can always use this pause hotkey, which will help you to pause your recording while you get readjusted to a different window or so. This next option is the show mouse cursor. Of course, when you are teaching a simulation software to your students, there will be different functions, keys, controls that you want to educate them upon. The mouse cursor visible while recording the screen is very useful, so please check this option. The next option that you need to check in is the add webcam overlay. Now, when you check this option, your video will appear on the screen as it is appearing for you right now on the left bottom corner. If you want to set that video more perfectly, you can go to the settings option over here. Now, if you go to the setting option over here, there are different settings here. We're starting with sound, webcam, mouse, logo, text and options. Start with sound, record sound. You can check all the other options. By default, it will pick up. But if it's not picking up your microphone properly, primary sound device, microphone, whichever microphone you have connected, check that option, give OK. Then next option is your webcam option. Always check in this option called add webcam overlay to the video. If you check the second option, get the overlay video as a separate file, which is not desirable by most of us. The next option that you need to set it up is the where your overlay should be available. So that we can set it up by clicking on this advanced option. Now this, when you click on this advanced option, the screen appears. Now, ideally, I always prefer the video screen is available here. But if you want to change that position, you can always change by preset positions over here. Now you can also change the overlay size. Now, can you see here overlay size? You can also change the overlay size. Now, apart from this, I can also change the position of my overlay video. As I can see here, I can change the position of my overlay video. Rest of the settings, I would say leave it out. It's not required for us to know as of now. Give OK. Now, the next option that you need to look up here is preview webcam on screen. Now, this is a very good option because when you're recording in front of your PPT, it's nice to see your video appearing on the bottom left or bottom right corner. So, click this option. Enable preview toggle hotkey tab, that is the shortcut is tab over here. Now this option is to enable if the video should be seen to you or not seen to you can be decided by just the key tab. We will now go back to the next setting, that is mouse. Now by default the mouse cursor can appear only when you click on this option show mouse cursor. Now you can also decide to increase the size of your mouse cursor key for better visibility. This next option, as you can see over here, is out mouse key click effect. When you click, should there be a color that comes around it and all those things. If you want that to happen, click on that add mouse click effect. The next option, as you can see, is add mouse highlight effect. Now, do you want to have an highlighted area? Like you can see over here, there's a highlighted area in yellow color. Now, this is what is the next option that you need to look into, adding a logo. If you want to add a logo, maybe of your university or your department, or of any other logo, or if you want to create a watermark to your video, you can add an or overlay a logo, and then you can also select its position where it should be. Now the image file root has to be given over here. Next is your text option. If you want to add some text to the screen, you can do that by coming to this text option. You can type in some text and click add, it will come to the screen. You can also edit the position of that text or the typo of that text and all those things, it can be edited. The next option is the options, and in this options, all the other options mentioned here I am not very much interested in, but the option that is mentioned over here for screen recording mode, that is show countdown timer before recording begins, please make sure that this is checked, because when you record a PPT, it will show you a countdown of 3 seconds before it start recording the screen and your video, so that you get ample time to get prepared for starting your talk. So it is a very useful option. Please keep it checked. Once you have done all these settings, give OK. Now all the settings required for using a Bandicam software is done. Rest all other settings that are available over there, leave it out as a default option is. Now remember, your recording happens when you press hotkey F12. Or your recording can also happen when you click on this record stop button here. I would highly recommend you to record by clicking on this hotkey F12. So I will show you a demo now how you can click on that hotkey and the video will appear on the bottom right. So I'll disable the video that is overlaid now. Now once you have done all the required settings, as you can see here, you can minimize this window called Bandicam. You can minimize this window. And you can click the option called F12. Now see what happens when I click this option called F12. Now remember, this is the option for record. Now can you see this countdown coming? 3, 2, 1. And then there's a click option. And then your video appears on the screen. Yeah. Does that look good? So this is literally that will appear on your screen when you're recording. So this is a more intuitive software. Then you can of course teach into your PPT. You can flip slides and the video will stay there. If you don't want the video to be seen, as I said to you before, click the tab option. And when you click the tab option, the video goes off. So you can decide when the video should be there. By clicking the tab option again, the video will come. Or clicking the tab option, the video will go off. Now when you want to stop your recording, again go back and click the F12 option. And the recording stops. Now let's move on to our editing option using OpenShot video editor. It's open source software. So whenever you open OpenShot video editor, this is the window that would appear normally to everyone. Now as I always say, before you start anything, save your project. Go to file, give, save the project. Okay, name it as you want it. Name the project as you want it and save it in the place where you are comfortable that project should be saved. Then the second option that you need to look up to is your timeline over here. This is a timeline option here. Now as you can see over here, there is track 1, track 2. If I scroll here, we have track 3, 4, track 5 is there. Now I would suggest have only one track to start for. So right click on this track to remove this track. Right click again on this, remove this track. Right click again on this track to remove this track. So when you keep on right clicking and click on remove track, only one track will be remaining over here. So just have one track. If you want to add a track, of course you can always add a track by clicking on this option called add. Now way to import files is click on this option called as import files. Can you see this option called as import files? When you click on this option, you get this option called as import files. Okay, and I just take maybe some one of you the videos that I want to edit. Okay, and I just open it. Yeah. So when I give open it, it should appear in my project files. Now to find your project files, please go to this option called as project files. Now click on this video over here and drag it and drop it on your timeline. This video you may like to edit. Other option to zoom in and zoom out on this video on this timeline is this option over here. As you can see, you can click on this option over here and zoom in and zoom out. Okay, you can zoom in or zoom out, or the other shortcut option is plus and minus on your keypad, which will zoom in or zoom out. Yeah. So now you can remove the area. For example, now if you don't want an introductory part, I would highly recommend when you do an edit, zoom in a bit to the video. Now if you say I don't want this much part over here, so bring the slider over here. Can you see the slider over here? Yeah, you click on that blue part over there and drag it and keep the slider on the portion that you want to edit. And can you see this option called as razor tool over here? Yeah, razor tool is the option to cut the track. Yeah, so use the razor tool. This option will come up. Keep this option on the slider and cut. The video has been cut into two tracks. Go to your razor tool again, click there. The cursor will again change to normal option. Now as you can see here, the video track has been split into two parts here. The part that you are not interested in, just right click on that. There is an option called as remove clip. So once you remove the clip, move the clip to the required position. In the same way, if you want to edit a part in between, the same way you can press the razor tool by placing the slider wherever you need. You can press the razor tool. So on the place where you like to cut the video again. Okay, now once you've done it, again press on the razor tool here so that it will go back to your normal mouse tool. Now once you've done this, you can also delete this video by right clicking and clicking this option called remove clip. Now once that happens, you can move this video over here. Yeah, so this is how we can edit either any part in the beginning, or edit any part in the between, or you can also edit a part in the end. Now apart from this, you can also edit by adding an image or a logo on this video tracks also, but I'm leaving it out for you to explore it. If you want to know more about it, please get in touch with me. My contact details will be furnished in the description below. When you have to export your video, finally click on this file option and you can see this option called export video. So when you click on this export video option, it will ask you a lot of details like what should be the file's name. I would recommend all the other options, leave it as it is. Remember the folder path where the video will be stored. Once this is done, give export video option. The exporting should start immediately. Yeah. Once the export is over, you can always go back and find the video in your folder path that you had given for saving your video. I believe this was a very simple exercise for you. By recording the video by using Bandicam and by editing the video using OpenShot software. Thank you.